Lord of Chaos begins with the Mundred as he arrives at Child Ghul to receive new orders from the Great Lord of the Dark. He informs the Great Lord that Ravine has been killed with Balefire and Lanfear and Mogideon have disappeared. After the Mundred receives new orders, he goes to a meeting with Massana, Samarag and Grendel and tells them that the Great Lord's new orders are to let the Lord of Chaos rule. We then see Gawain Trakand, who is under the command of a group of soldiers called the Younglings, who sided with Alaida during the White Tower split. Gawain and the Younglings are escorting a group of Aes Sedai to Cairhien. The Aes Sedai want to speak to the Dragon Reborn about coming with them to the White Tower. On the road, the Aes Sedai stop to speak to Savannah, the new leader of the Shadow Aiel, and Gawain speaks to a peddler that tells him that the dragon has conquered Camelin and that according to rumor also killed his mother, Queen Morghaes. Gawain's new mission is to avenge his mother and kill Randall Thor. Morghaes Trakand is in Amadicia speaking to the king. Morghaes is looking for allies to retake Andor from Lord Gabriel. After the king leaves, Pedro Nile, the Lord Captain Commander of the Children of the Light, walks into her room to speak to her. He tells Morghaes that the dragon Randall Thor has taken Camelin after killing Lord Gabriel and that he can help her retake Andor from him by giving her 5,000 Children of the Light. Morghaes tells Pedro Nile that she will think about it and after some time she realizes that she doesn't have a choice, so she agrees to Pedro Nile's deal. Aemon Balda and Radha Masunawa are two high-ranking members of the Children of the Light who don't agree with Pedro Nile's recent decisions. They think that he will ruin the Children of the Light, so the two start plotting against him. Meanwhile, in the Two Rivers, Fael Bashir Ivara is holding court in her new manor house. The Two Rivers is still recovering from the Trolloc attacks, and there's also many refugees from many different places. After Fael settles many arguments, she goes to speak to her husband, Lord Perrin Ivara, and Perrin tells her that he's leaving the Two Rivers to reunite with Rand. He feels that Rand is tugging at him, and he knows that Rand needs him. Perrin wants to go by himself, but Fael will not let him, so she arranges an escort to go with them and search for the Dragon Reborn. Nynaeve is in Salidar, studying Swan and Lian's stillness. She's trying to find a way to heal stillness, but so far she hasn't been successful. Nynaeve has a very dangerous secret. After she learned where Mogideon was in the last book, she went after her and put an atom around her neck, and she now has her prisoner and has learned many useful things from the Forsaken. Elaine now knows how to make new Tarangriel, something that has not been known since the Age of Legends, and she created the atom that is around Mogideon's neck. After she learns that the Revel Aes Sedai are sending an embassy to Camelin to speak to Rand, Elaine gets very angry because she is not allowed to go with them. The embassy has 9 Aes Sedai and Min. Elaine goes to speak to Min about Rand because she knows that one of Min's viewings about Rand is him being shared by 3 women, 2 of them being her and Min. Elaine is worried that this could damage their friendship, but Min assures her that that won't happen, and then she leaves with the rest of the embassy. Elaine and Nynaeve have been teaching the Revel Aes Sedai about Telaranriad. Elaine made many copies of the Ring Terangriel that allows them to go into Telaranriad, and now multiple Aes Sedai can go into it at the same time. One night, they go to the White Tower in Telaranriad to learn about recent news and to spy on Alaida. They learn some useful things, including the fact that Alaida has also sent an embassy to speak to Rand. Suddenly, Elaine and Swan hear some Aes Sedai screaming, and they realize that the Aes Sedai got caught in a nightmare. Elaine tells them that the nightmare is not real and to not believe in it, but the Aes Sedai are panicking and they don't listen. Elaine and Swan go into the nightmare and they manage to rescue the Aes Sedai by convincing them that the nightmare is not real. Afterwards, they return to the real world with many bruises and scars. Elaine and Nynaeve are frustrated with the Aes Sedai, because even though they warn them about nightmares and other dangers in Telaranriad, the Aes Sedai won't listen to them and they think that they know everything. The next day, Nynaeve makes Mogideon teach her how to detect when a man is channeling, when suddenly Elaine walks in and tells Nynaeve that an emissary from the White Tower has arrived. Elaine and Nynaeve try to eavesdrop on the meeting the Revel Aes Sedai are having with the emissary, but they can't. They're worried that the Revel Aes Sedai will agree to return to the White Tower and join Elaida, so Elaine and Nynaeve go into Telaranriad to look for something that will convince the Revel Aes Sedai to join Rand instead of Elaida. In Telaranriad, they use Need, which is a technique that Nynaeve learned from the Wise Ones in Book 4. When they focus on what they need, they are teleported to a place where they find a Terangreal that looks like a crystal ball called the Ball of the Winds. Elaine tells Nynaeve that this place is located in Ebudar. The next day, the White Tower emissary leaves, and the Revel Aes Sedai announce that they will not join Elaida in the White Tower, and they will remain in Salidar. Elaine and Nynaeve tell Shiri Aes Sedai that they want to go to Evudar to look for the Ball of the Winds that they found in Telaranriad, but Shiri Aes Sedai doesn't allow them to go. Nynaeve is still trying to heal Stilling, and she goes to study Loghain. After trying for some time, she jumps as she realizes that she has just healed him. Nynaeve immediately shields Loghain and sends Elaine to tell the Aes Sedai what she just did. No one believes what Elaine is claiming, so Nynaeve walks towards Swan and Leon and heals them both. Now we go over to Randall Thor, who is in Camelin practicing sword fighting with 5 of the best swordsmen. Out of nowhere, Devran Bashir throws a dagger at Rand, and Rand stops it with the One Power. Lord Bashir does this to demonstrate to Rand that channeling is more effective than the sword. Rand's next target is the Forsaken Samael, who is in Ilion. He, Matt, and Lord Bashir have already made a battle plan to defeat the Forsaken. A man comes to tell Rand and Bashir that the false dragon Masram Taim has just arrived to speak to Rand. Devran Bashir hates Masram Taim because he caused a lot of damage and destruction in his homeland when Taim declared himself the Dragon Reborn. But now, Taim is taking advantage of Rand's amnesty and wants to join him. Taim gives Rand a seal to the Dark One's prison that he says was given to him. Rand accepts him and he takes Taim to the farm. The farm is pretty much the White Tower, but for men, and it's filled with men and their families as they wait to learn if they can channel. Rand doesn't know how to test someone to see if they can channel, but Taim does. So Rand makes Masram Taim the leader and teacher of the farm. Rand tells Taim to gather as many male channelers as he can, and then he leaves. Rand goes to speak to his allies about his plan of attack against Samael, but he doesn't reveal his true plan, just in case Samael has spies. Then we see Matt Cawthon, who is at an inn drinking and dancing, before he has to go to Ilion to take down Samael. When he goes outside, he notices that there's a lot of hunters for the horn, which reminds him of his bond to the Horn of Valir. He spots a hunter of the horn beating a little boy, and he goes to rescue him. The boy is named Alvar, and he says that both his mother and father are dead, so Matt decides to take care of him. The next morning, Matt and the Band of the Red Hand start marching south towards Tyr. On the road, they come across a tinker caravan, and they find all of the tinkers dead. Because of this, Matt can't sleep at night, so he goes outside to think. He hears noises around his tent, and spots Aiel searching his tent. He immediately warns the camp, and they manage to defeat them. Matt investigates where the Aiel came from, and he notices that they use a gateway, which means that the Aiel were sent by one of the Forsaken. Back in Camelin, Rand learns that 2 Aes Sedai are staying in the city, so Rand goes to see them. When he walks into the inn they are staying at, he finds a lot of familiar faces. There's about a dozen girls from the Two Rivers, including Bothwen Cawthon, who is Matt's sister. Bothwen tells Rand that they're traveling with Verin and Alana Aes Sedai because all of them can channel and they're going to become Aes Sedai. Then the girls tell him about the Trolloc attacks in the Two Rivers and how Perrin saved them and then married Fael. Rand goes to speak to Verin and Alana in private, and Alana gets very close to him and does something to Rand. Rand freaks out and shields both of them, then he orders Alana to tell him what she did to him. Alana tells him that she bonded him as her warder. An Aes Sedai making someone their warder without consent is very much against Aes Sedai customs, and it hasn't been done in a long time. Rand orders them to stay away from him, and then he leaves. He goes to the farm to see how things are going there, and he notices that he feels Alana's presence and feelings through the water bond. He also keeps hearing Louis Theron Telemann's voice in his head, which is driving him crazy, but he tries to ignore it. At the farm, Masrum Tahim tells him that things are going very well with the training, but he wants to leave the farm to go recruit more male channelers. He promises Rand that if he lets him go, he will have an army that will rival the White Tower. Rand thinks about it for a moment, and then he agrees. Rand goes to the royal palace in Camelin to meet with some of the most important nobles in Camelin. The nobles have heard many rumors about Rand, and they don't trust him. Rand tells them that he doesn't want to be the king of Andor, he wants Elaine to take the throne, but some of the nobles don't agree with this decision. During the meeting, one of the nobles keeps looking at Rand in a very strange way. This person tells him that he reminds her of Tigraine. Tigraine was the daughter heir of Andor until she disappeared. After Rand learns the story of Tigraine, he realizes that her story fits with the story he learned from the wise ones about his mother. Rand realizes that Tigraine was his real mother. Before Tigraine disappeared, she had one son, Galad Damodred, which makes him and Galad half-brothers. Bashir tells Rand that the Forsaken Samael has sent an emissary to deliver a message. The emissary tells Rand that Samael is proposing a truce. Samael won't attack Rand as long as Rand leaves him alone until the last battle, but Rand rejects this proposition and says that he won't be making any truce with any Forsaken. He then makes a gateway to Kyrian and goes to check the school he set up in the city. The school has many students and researchers, and so far they have made many interesting inventions. Rand speaks to Herod Fell, who is a philosopher at the school, and asks him about the water bond, hoping that he knows how to break it, but Fell doesn't know much about the subject. When Rand goes back to Camelin, he's told that three Ogier have arrived to see him. The Ogier are looking for Loyal because Loyal's mother has found the perfect wife for him. Rand tells them that Loyal is safe in the Two Rivers. Then Rand remembers that the Ogier know where all of the gateways in the Westlands are located, and he asks them to tell him where they are because he knows that the Shadowspawn use the gateways to travel faster, so he wants to close them. The Ogier agree to help him, and they mark the waygates on a map. Rand realizes that one gateway is located in Shadow Loga, so he decides to go there right away since he already knows the place. Rand makes a gateway to Shadow Loga, and he's accompanied by the Ogier and the Maidens of the Spear. Rand warns everyone about the dangers of Shadow Loga, and when they get there, they all get creeped out by the place. Even the voice of Louis Theron in Rand's head agrees. Rand sets a little trap in the gateway that will kill any Shadowspawn that uses it. As they're leaving Shadow Loga, they realize that one Maiden of the Spear is missing. After they search for her for a long time, they can't find her, and Rand decides to leave because at night, Mashadar comes out. He makes a gateway to the Two Rivers and leaves the Ogier there so they can reach Loyal faster. Then he returns to Camelin with the Maidens of the Spear. Back in Kyrian, Egwene is walking around the city after finally recovering from the battle against Lanfear in the last book. She was severely injured, and during her recovery she spent a lot of time in Telaranriad. At one point she came across Gawain's dream and learned that he is in love with her. Egwene spots a group of Aes Sedai, and she realizes that it is the White Tower Embassy. She immediately goes to warn the Wise Ones, and she finds Berlane with them. Rand put Berlane in charge of Kyrian temporarily, and Egwene is surprised to see that the Wise Ones really like her. Egwene tells the Wise Ones that she doesn't trust the White Tower Aes Sedai after all that has happened in the White Tower, so they start making plans on how to protect Rand from them. When Egwene goes out into the city, she comes across Gawain, and they both confess their love for each other. Gawain tells her that Rand killed his mother, and Egwene tells him that Rand wouldn't do that, but Gawain doesn't believe her. Egwene tells him not to do anything to Rand until she can prove to him that Rand didn't kill Morghaes, and Gawain agrees. She then goes to see Rand, and she warns him about the White Tower Embassy. Rand knows not to trust them, because before Moraine died, she left him a letter telling him not to trust any Aes Sedai. Rand is then told that three Aes Sedai from the White Tower Embassy have arrived to see him. Rand makes a weave around Egwene that makes her invisible and he speaks to them. The White Tower Embassy offers Rand a chest full of gold, and in exchange they want him to go with them to the White Tower so that they can protect him from any danger. Rand says that he will go to the White Tower, but not before he takes care of some things. Then he dismisses the Aes Sedai. After the meeting, Egwene and the Wise Ones go to Tel Aranria to speak to the Salidar Aes Sedai. Egwene is ordered by the Aes Sedai to join them in Salidar immediately. Egwene thinks that she is in trouble for pretending to be an Aes Sedai during her time with the Aiel. The Wise Ones now consider Egwene an Aiel, and they tell her that if she is turned away by the Aes Sedai, she can always join them. To get to Salidar faster, Egwene does something that no one has done before, as far as she knows. She creates a waygate into Tel Aranria and goes there in the flesh. Then she imagines Vella and summons her. She starts riding towards Salidar and arrives there in no time. Once in Salidar, she is updated on everything that has happened, including Nynaeve's new ability to heal stealing. Egwene is told that she wasn't summoned because she is in trouble. She was summoned because she is to be made the Revel Aes Sedai's Amarlan Seed. She is told that even though she's not Aes Sedai, she can still be chosen as the Amarlan, and once she becomes the Amarlan, she also becomes Aes Sedai. Egwene agrees, and after a ceremony, she becomes the Revel Aes Sedai's Amarlan Seed. Egwene meets with Nynaeve and Alayne, and they tell her about the Vol of the Winds that they believe could fix the weather. Recently, it has been very hot, and they believe it's because the Dark One's presence in the world is affecting the weather. Egwene agrees to send them to Evudar to search for the Tarangreal, and she also decides to raise them to Aes Sedai. The next day, Matt and Alvienda appear in Salidar. Rand learned where Alayne was by spying on Egwene in Tel Aranria and decided to change his plans. He teleported Matt and his band of the Red Hand to Salidar so he could bring Alayne back to Camelin to be crowned the new Queen of Andor. And Alvienda came to apologize to Alayne for sleeping with Rand. When Matt hears that Egwene is the Amarlan, he thinks it's a joke, but after he learns that it's not, he leaves and goes to see Ton Marilyn, and he gives him a letter that Moraine left for him before she died. Alvienda tells Alayne that she betrayed her by sleeping with Rand, but after Alayne remembers Min's viewing of Rand being shared by three women, she realizes that the third woman is Alvienda, so she forgives her. The next day, Matt is given the choice to either leave Salidar alone or go with Nynaeve and Alayne to Evudar to search for the Ball of the Winds. Matt promised Rand that he will bring Alayne back to Camelin safely, so he decides to go with them to Evudar and keep them safe. Before he leaves Talmanes in charge of the band. Talmanes is Matt's second in command and orders him to follow the Revel Aes Sedai wherever they go. When they reach Evudar, Alayne and Nynaeve speak to Tylin, who is the Queen of Evudar, and they tell her that they're searching for the Ball of the Winds. Queen Tylin thinks that it might be located in a place called the Rihad, and after searching for some time, they're unsuccessful, but they keep on searching. In Salidar, Egwene makes two drastic decisions. First, she decides to take the Revel Aes Sedai out of Salidar, and with Garrett Brynn's army, they start marching towards Tar Valon, and then she lets the false dragon Loghain escape. Back in Camelin, Min and the Revel Aes Sedai embassy finally arrive, and Min immediately goes to see Rand. As soon as she sees him, she has a viewing. After they speak for some time, Min tells him about the viewing. She says that he will be harmed by the Aes Sedai, but she doesn't know which group of Aes Sedai. After some time, Min leaves, and Rand goes to the farm and notices a greater number of students practicing. Masrim Taim tells him that the students have changed the name of the farm to the Black Tower, and Rand likes the name, so he decides to keep it. He tells Taim to gather the students and announces a ranking system like in the White Tower, but instead of calling themselves Aes Sedai, they will be Ashaman, which means guardian in the old tongue. Perrin Ivara and his group arrive at Camelin. He goes to see Rand, and Rand is very happy to see his friend. They talk about the two rivers and Perrin's marriage to Fael. Rand tells Perrin about Moraine, the White Tower, and the Forsaken. Perrin then goes to meet Daevram and Daira Bashir, who are now Perrin's in-laws. At first, they don't approve of him marrying their daughter, Fael, but eventually, they grow to like him. Loyal goes to see Rand, and Rand tells him about his mother looking for him. Loyal knows that she wants him to marry Aerys, who Loyal really likes. Min then arrives and tells Rand that two more Aes Sedai have arrived in Camelin. This makes Rand angry, because there's now 13 Aes Sedai in Camelin, and he knows that 13 Aes Sedai linked together can easily overtake him, so he leaps for Cairhien with all of his friends and the Maidens of the Spear. In Cairhien, Rand still has the White Tower embassy to deal with, and after many attempts to meet with him, he finally allows three of them to go see him. When Rand meets with the Aes Sedai, he feels them channeling and he tries to shield them, but he is unable to because he has been shielded instead. There were Aes Sedai disguised as servants, and now there are 15 of them in the room. Rand is powerless, and the Aes Sedai put him in a big chest and they kidnap him. Perrin and the Aiel spend 6 days trying to locate Rand, and it's not until Berlin finds Rand's sword, which Rand never leaves behind, that they realize that he has somehow been taken by Elida's Aes Sedai. Perrin and the Aiel gather their forces and they start chasing the Aes Sedai. Perrin uses the wolves to track down the Aes Sedai, and when he tells them that Shadowkiller has been taken, they also join the hunt. On the road, they find Alana and the Saladar embassy, who have been following Rand by using Alana's water bond. After they learned what happened to Rand, they also joined the rescue team. Rand gets tortured by the White Tower Aes Sedai, and one day Rand realizes that Min was also taken. When he sees her, he tries to help her, and he kills two warders with his bare hands. After this, he gets tortured even more. Rand then starts having conversations with Lois Darren Telemann, and the two begin to work together to escape this trap. Sivana and Ashido have made a deal with the White Tower Aes Sedai, and the two groups begin to work together to take Rand to the White Tower. Sivana wants to marry Rand and become the wife of the Karakarn, and therefore also become the leader of the Aiel. And Elida's Aes Sedai want the Shido to kill Gawain and the younglings once they reach Tar Valon. After some time, Perrin and his forces catch up to Rand, and the Battle of Dumai's Wells begins. Perrin and his allies didn't know that the Shido would be here, and they are outnumbered, but they are determined to rescue Rand. The wolves join the fight, and then a gateway opens and the Ashaman appear. Rand and Lewis Theron manage to finally break the shield, and he immediately goes to rescue Min, and then shields the Aes Sedai. Without the Aes Sedai channeling, Perrin, the wolves, the Aiel, and the Ashaman begin to overwhelm the Shido, and Gawain and his younglings escape the battle. The Ashaman make a dome of air around the Shido, and Rand decides to set an example. He orders Masrim Taim to show him what the Ashaman are capable of. The Ashaman turn the giant dome of air into a giant meat grinder, and one by one, the Shido began to explode into hundreds of pieces. After the battle, Sivana and some of the Shido manage to escape, but the White Tower Aes Sedai are not so lucky. Rand has them on their knees, and when the Saladar Aes Sedai go to congratulate him on his victory, he orders them to also get on their knees. Rand then makes all of the Aes Sedai swear fealty to him, and the world is changed forever.